Types of direct tax. In this tutorial, we shall discuss different types of direct tax. This lesson is important in the sense both questions appear from it. I shall present a few questions here. Define proportional tax and show it graphically. 2011. Differentiate between degressive taxation and regressive taxation. 2014. What is progressive tax? 2020. Well, direct tax is one which is to be paid by the person on whom the tax is imposed. It is mostly levied on the income of individuals and corporates. While applying a tax rate, income becomes the basis. Tax is classified as proportional tax, progressive tax, regressive tax, and degressive tax. We shall see them one by one with numerical examples and their effect on income distribution with graphs. Proportional taxation. Under proportional taxation, uniform tax rate is applied on income. Look at this table. Tax rate doesn't change with income. The rate of tax is fixed in terms of certain percentage. Individuals' income may be high or low, but each one has to pay tax at a fixed rate. Income of the individuals A, B, C, D, and E changes from 5,000 rupees to 25,000 rupees. Each individual pays only 5% of his income. In other words, each individual has to pay 5% of the income by way of tax. Though the tax rate is the same, the actual amount increases with income. An important point to be noted here is the income inequality among the individuals. Look at this graph. The blue color line shows the income distribution before tax. The orange color line shows the income distribution after tax. The disparity is reduced only marginally after paying the tax. The relation between tax rate and the income can be shown in the form of graph. The TR is the tax rate curve. It shows that tax rate is the same for all ranges of income. The curve is parallel to x-axis. Progressive taxation. Under this system, tax rate increases with increase in income. Look at this table. 5% tax is imposed on 5,000 rupees income. 10% is applied on 10,000 rupees income. Thus, tax rate grows progressively with income. A lower tax rate is applied to lower income. A higher tax rate is applied to higher income. Let us see what happens to inequality in income after tax. In this graph also, the blue color line shows income distribution before tax. Orange color line shows income distribution after tax. The disparity in income distribution after tax is reduced to a marked extent. Look at this graph. It brings out the relation between tax rate and income. The curve TR is sloping upwards. It shows the tax rate increases with increase in income. Regressive taxation. Under this, tax rate falls with increase in income. This table illustrates regressive taxation. Relatively low income group is subjected to higher tax rate. 10% tax is levied on 5,000 rupees income, whereas 6% tax rate is applied on 25,000 rupees income. Though the tax rate falls, the actual amount of tax to be paid by higher income group is more than the low income group. For example, while a person receiving 5,000 rupees pays 500 rupees, a person receiving 25,000 rupees pays 1,500 by way of tax. In absolute terms, though higher income group pays more tax, relatively speaking, money burden for the low income group is very heavy. We shall examine the income inequality after tax. Income inequality almost remains unaffected after tax. This type of taxation cannot be used as a tool to reduce unequal distribution of income among the citizens. Okay, such a regressive type of income tax was practiced by some Western European countries in the early 19th century. They used it mainly to make the people to work more and earn more and pay less tax. Let us represent regressive taxation in the form of a graph. The downward sloping tax rate curve TR shows a fall in the tax rate with increase in tax base, that is income. Degressive taxation. Degressive taxation is a combination of progressive tax and proportional tax. Look at this table. To begin with, progressive taxation is applied. The tax rate increases from 5% to 10% when income increases from 5,000 rupees to 10,000 rupees. After that, proportional tax rate is applied. For income level 15,000 rupees and above, a uniform tax rate of 20% is applied. Let us see its effect on income distribution. It also reduces the income inequality, but not as less as proportional taxation and not as more as progressive taxation. It lies in between the two. Its effect on income redistribution is moderate. The graph illustrates degressive taxation. TR is the tax rate curve. It slopes upward initially. Tax rate increases with the tax base. After that, the curve is flat and parallel to x-axis. Tax rate remains the same irrespective of income. Our discussion on types of direct tax ends here. We shall meet in the next lesson.